Welcome to the lecture series of Z transform. Today we are going to see a very important problem under Z transform. Look at the question. Find Z of sequence n into a power n. So here this bracket notation for sequence. So we know very well that by the definition of Z transform, Z of n into a power n is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into a power n z power minus n, which is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into a power n. Now this z power minus n can be written as z power n. So now sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into, this can be written as a by z whole power n. Now we are going to give values for n. If it is first value is 0, 0 into anything will become as 0. So we can start our n value from 1. So which is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity n into a by z whole power n. Now n is equal to 1. So 1 into a by z whole power 1 plus n equal to 2. So 2 into a by z power 2 plus n equal to 3. 3 into a by z power 3 plus etc. As we know very well that for all the result 1 plus x, 1 minus x, the first term should be 1. So here we can take the a by z outside. So what is the remaining? 1 plus 2 into a by z plus 3 into a by z the whole square plus etc. Now this is of the form 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus etc. The result is 1 minus x whole power minus 2. In the place of x, here we are having a by z. So which is equal to a by z into 1 minus x, x is a by z whole power minus 2. Now this can be written as a by z into z minus a divided by z whole power minus 2. So now this can be written as a by z into z square divided by z minus a the whole square. Now we can cancel the z and the square. So which is equal to a z divided by z minus a the whole square. What is our left hand side? Left hand side is z transform of sequence n into a power n equal to a z divided by z minus a the whole square. This is what the answer for the sequence n into a power n. Now look at the second question. Find Z transform of sequence n into a power n minus 1. So by the same manner, here also we can start with the Z transform. Z of n into a power n minus 1 equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into a power n minus 1 z power minus n, which is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into a power n minus 1 z power minus n, adding and subtracting by 1. So in the, as usual in the next step, for the z power minus 1, a power n minus 1 z power minus n plus 1 into z power minus 1. This is z power minus 1, we can write it as 1 by z. Here there is no n, that's why we are writing outside of the sigma. So n equal to 0 to infinity n into a power n minus 1 divided by z power n minus 1. So this can be written as 1 by z sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into a by z whole power n minus 1. So now we are going to give values for n. As usual, when n equal to 0, 0 into anything whole term will become as 0. So we will start, the first value of n is 1. So 1 by z sigma n equal to 1 to infinity n into a by z whole power n minus 1. So now we will start to give the values for n. First value of n is 1. So 1 into 1 minus 1 0, anything power 0 is 1. So our first value is 1 plus n equal to 2. So 2 into a by z whole power 2 minus 1 1. Then n equal to 3. So 3 into a by z square plus n equal to 4, 4 into a by z the whole cube plus etc. So in this is 1 by z. So 1 by z into one minus a by z whole power minus 2, so which is equal to 1 by z z minus a divided by z whole power minus 2, that is 1 by z z square divided by z minus a the whole square. You can cancel z and the square, so which is equal to z by z minus a the whole square. So what is our left hand side? Left hand side is z transform of n into a power n minus 1, which is equal to z by z minus a the whole square. So z transform of sequence n into a power n minus 1 equal to z by z minus a the whole square. This is what the answer. Thank you for watching.